this beginner's tutorial, we will talk about how to open, save and close your images, about resizing and cropping, about the color balance, the hue and saturation, and the brightness and contrast. When we have downloaded and installed GIMP, it will open in three separate windows. We can change this by clicking on Windows in the menu bar and then on Single Window Mode. Click Full Screen. We can change the width of the toolbox on the left by placing the cursor on the edge until it changes in a little double arrow. Dragging it to the right makes it easier to read the text in the tool options. The next time we open GIMP, it will open with these settings. Scale or resize. Go to File, click Open. And here we can search for our image folder. Throughout these tutorials, we will mostly use JPG's images. When you have found your image folder, don't open it yet, but select it by clicking once. By clicking on the plus icon, we can add this folder to the list, which makes it easier to find the next time we need it. Now open the image folder by double-clicking. Select the image and check the preview whether it is the right one. Click Open. Now we go to Image in the menu bar and click Scale Image. We can see the current resolution. Make sure that the chain icon is locked so the width and the height stay in proportion. Type in the new width and hit Enter, and you can see the new resolution. Click Scale. Go to View, Zoom, and then Fit Image in Window. To save the scaled image, we go to File and then Export As. Here we can type a new name. The extension stays JPG. Hit Enter. Click Export. We can now close the image by clicking on the little cross icon and then discard changes. In this way, the original image stays intact. We now have the original as well as the scaled image in our image folder. Crop an image. Click File and then Open. Go to the previously added image folder, open it and search for your image. Select it and check the preview whether it's the right one and hit Enter or click Open. Go to View, Zoom, Fit Image in Window for maximum visibility. Go to the toolbox and select the crop tool. Place the cursor in the image, left click and hold, and drag the selection. With left click and hold again, we can drag the handles on the top, the bottom, left and right to change the selected area. We can also grab one of the corners and move it in every direction. By placing the cursor somewhere in the middle, we can move the whole selection. To remove the selection and make a new one, we can click outside the selection. When we want to apply the selection, we can double-click somewhere in the area or click one time in one of the corners. To undo the last action, we go to Edit and click Undo Crop Image. Now go to Tool Option and click Fixed Aspect Ratio. Type in the desired aspect ratio, for example 16:9. When we make the selection, the aspect ratio will stay the same, regardless how we change or correct it. When we have made our selection, we can double-click somewhere in the middle, or one time in one of the corners to crop the image. Go to File. We can overwrite our image, but for now we go to Export As. Here we type a new image name and hit Enter. We can leave the default quality as it is and click Export. We can close GIMP, click Discard Changes, so the original as well as the cropped image are saved in our image folder. Color Balance. This time we will open our image with drag and drop. Make sure your image folder is open and click it to the foreground. Now with left click and hold, select your image, drag and drop it into GIMP. When we hold the Ctrl key, we can zoom in or out by turning the mouse wheel. With the scroll bar on the right and at the bottom, we can position our image. Go to Color and then Color Balance. Left click and hold and grab at the top of the window to move it aside. We can correct the shadows, the midtones and the highlights separately. For now we will use only the midtones. You can experiment with the color levels and click Reset to go back. In this case, the image is too red. We can change this by adding cyan, but we can do this also by adding green and blue separately. On the right, we can use little triangles to fine-tune our corrections. Clicking Preview shows us how it was and how it is now. Click OK when you're satisfied with the result. Go to File, click Export As, and rename your image. As you can see, the file extension stays JPG. Hit Enter or click Export, and click Export to save it. Close the image and click Discard Changes to save the original image. Now we have the corrected image and the original image in our image folder. Hue and Saturation. Another way to open an image is by first opening your image folder. Right-click on the thumbnail of the image you want to open. Click Open With and then GIMP. In this section of the tutorial, we will work with two different images, so I will open the second one in the same way. Here we can switch between the two images. Now go to Colors in the menu bar and click Use Saturation. If necessary, we can move the window aside by left click and hold in the top of the window and then drag it out of the way. When we move the Hue slider, we can see various color effects. In this way we can create a nice effect by shifting all the colors. The white in the image stays relatively unchanged, which let the changed colors pop out. When we move the saturation slider all the way to the left, we end up with a black and white image. However, this image would need some work with the brightness and contrast tool. We are going to cancel without saving, and then close the image. Another way to open the Hue Saturation tool is by clicking Tools, Color Tools, and then Hue Saturation. Here we have a very pale image with rather dull colors. The first thing we will do is making it darker by moving the brightness slider to the left. we can see the effect while we do this. This is also the case when we increase the saturation by moving the saturation slider to the right. We can fine-tune if necessary and click Preview to compare the image without and with the corrections. When the result is to our liking, we click OK. Then go to File and Export As. Type in a new name and hit Enter. Click Export. Close GIMP and click Discard Changes. You can see in the image folder that you now have the edited image and also the original. Brightness and contrast. Go to File, Open, and then to your image folder. Select your image and check the preview to be sure it is the right one. Click Open or hit Enter. Go to Colors in the menu bar and then click Brightness and Contrast. By moving the brightness slider and the contrast slider, we can see the effect immediately. This way, we can try out different settings and click Preview to see the difference. We now have still details in the darkest part and the highlights look bright. If we are satisfied with the result, we can click OK. Now we go to File and then Overwrite Mercedes 2 and click Export. Close the image and click Discard Changes. In this way, we only have the edited image in our image folder and no longer the original. I hope this was helpful. If so, please like, subscribe and leave a nice comment. Thanks for watching. Thank you.